On July 14, the Supreme Court took suo motu cognizance of an Indian Express report about the Uttar Pradesh government allowing the annual Kavar Yatra in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic. The Kavar Yatra is a pilgrimage for devotees of Lord Shiva. They walk barefoot with pitchers of water taken from holy rivers to different temples of Lord Shiva in parts of North India. The Uttarakhand government suspended it due to fear of it turning into another COVID super spreader event.
जबकि कोरोना महामारी और हमारे यहाँ पर अभी वेरिएंट एक वहाँ पर गदरपुर में पाया गया, तो हरिद्वार को हम जो है एक कोरोना महामारी का केंद्र नहीं बनाना चाहते हैं। लोगों का जीवन हमारे लिए प्राथमिकता है, हम उससे बिल्कुल भी खिलवाड़ नहीं कर सकते, उसमें हम कोई कोताही नहीं बरतेंगे, इसलिए हमने यात्रा स्थगित करने का फैसला किया।
However, UP has stuck with its decision to hold the Kavar Yatra from July 25th to August 6th.
Generally, the yatra from where they take the water and the yatra to the Shiva temples, it's mostly more than 100 kilometers and traveled on foot. But if you talk about the most important places from where the water is collected, then it is Haridwar and Gaumukh and Gangotri in Uttarakhand. Then there is Sultanganj in Bihar, then there is Prayagraj and Varanasi and Ayodhya in Uttar Pradesh. So the water is taken from these places, and from there the pilgrims travel to different, one of the 12 Jyotirlingas. A lot of devotees carry this water to their hometowns, and if there is a Shiva temple over there, they offer the water to Lord Shiva. In 2019, the Uttarakhand government gave an estimate that over 4 crore devotees arrived in their state. And the authorities in Uttar Pradesh itself have confirmed that over 2 to 3 crore devotees are coming to the western part of the state. So because there is a huge crowd involved, like any other religious procession such as Durga Puja or Ganesh Visarjan or Muharram, the Kavad Yatra also exerts tremendous pressure on the law and order. And in the last few years, this Kavad Yatra has hit headlines for all the possible wrong reasons. There have been fatal road accidents and stampede deaths. Then have been incidents where the Kavariyas, attacked the vehicles, including police vehicles also. Definitely, there is a lot of, fear of this event might being a super spreader, because all the things which result in a massive spread of this virus are present in this particular thing. There will be a lot of people gathering at particular places which include water bodies. They will be traveling to different temples, and not just gathering at a certain place, they will be traveling. They will be spending nights somewhere. They will be probably going to hotels and all these places. So definitely there is a lot of challenge. And as of now, there is no detailed plan on what the state government is planning to do that. But based on whatever information we have so far, they are planning to set up COVID booths, which will have the availability of masks and sanitizers and gloves and pulse oximeters and all the basic facilities which a COVID booth requires. And other than that, they are also considering making RT-PCR negative tests mandatory for the devotees who are willing to participate in that. But as of now, they are going ahead with the yatra, and while following all the COVID protocols and all the plans related to law and order, they are going ahead with the same as of now.